I can tell you've been crying and you're needing somebody to talk to. Girl, I can tell he's been lying and pretending that he's faithful and he loves you. Girl, you don't have to be hiding. Don't you be ashamed to say he hurt you. I'm your girl, you're my girl, we're your girls. Don't you
know that?
Hello,
hello, hello. Hey. Welcome to Girl the Podcast.
I'm Whit.
I'm Alex.
Yeah. Happy to have you back.
Yay.
Let's get into these current eventos.
Yes. So, current news that I have, a mother reported her son missing in March, and police kept the truth from her for months. This happened in Jackson, Mississippi. Betterstein Wade searched for her adult son, ended when she discovered that an officer had run him over without telling her.
I saw that on Twitter.
Yeah.
I think that's very sad, honestly. Like, because how can you do that to a mother? Like,
exactly. Especially because I had, kept reading it. And they said they knew his name, but, like, just failed to, like, contact her and let her know that her son was, like, you know, dead.
Yeah. Which I feel like they did that shit on purpose.
Yeah.
Like, there's no way they didn't do that shit.
They did. They definitely did. Because they ran him over. Yeah. And then you gonna just bury him in the unmarked number grave. And just, that's it. You just don't care about him. Don't care about his family or just anything. So, it's very sad. It's just sad to see, honestly. And I don't know. I just want better for the police system and our black lives.
Like, that's why we don't trust the police.
Yes.
They do shit like that. Like,
I get terrified when I get pulled over by the police.
You been pulled over?
Not recently, but like whenever I do, like when I'm in a car with like my family. So yeah, I'll be scared.
Yeah, terrified.
I'll be terrified. Like, mm-mm.
One time, me and my boyfriend and his friends, we was at Domino's, about to get some Domino's, and then we hotboxed the car, and the police pulled up to the parking lot. We was in fucking Menominee Falls, my old apartment. Yeah, police pull up, girl. I'm shaking like a fucking stripper in the backseat. I'm like, my boyfriend had to calm me down.
Yeah.
And I feel like damn near embarrassed because his friend was sitting right next to me and I'm just like, I know she felt me shaking.
I mean, but hey, if you scared, you scared.
I was terrified.
I'd be scared too, especially after a fresh hot box.
I'm like, I can't do the police. I don't want everyone to be in a situation where I have to be like around them.
Okay.
Ugh, fuck the police.
Fuck 12.
Coming straight from the underground. I'm gonna get kind of bad because I'm brown.
Oh my gosh.
Period. Okay. That's very sad though. Like, yeah. When I read that story, I was like,
imagine her heartbreak. Like, just like, she's just searching for her son and she just.
Yeah. Yeah, because like 7 months, bro.
7 months. And it's like, we supposed to call on the police, you know, for help and stuff.
Yeah.
And it's just like, goodness, like, y'all knew the whole time and didn't do nothing about it. Didn't try to tell her nothing.
Especially because, like, she kept calling for an update. So
exactly.
Like,
y'all knew.
Yeah. They covered that shit up, definitely. My current event or news or whatever was given to me by Destiny. Shout out to Destiny, girl. We used to work together at Lowe's. Basically, if you be on dating apps, you should be cautious and be alert, because a man named Matthew Berry, he is like an abuser, and he killed his girlfriend's dogs. He actually has to pay $160K to his ex-girlfriend because he tortured and killed her dogs.
That's a psychopath. That's the first sign.
The first sign, yes. And then they met on a fucking dating app. So, and they both connected over their interest in dogs. Yeah.
That's scary.
Very scary. And then it says, like, a month later, Barry became verbally abusive to her and physically abusive to her dogs. Like, he injected medication into one dog and it died the next day, while the second dog died a month later. Yeah, so...
I mean, after the first dog, she didn't... She didn't scratch her head like, what?
Like,
yeah, like, what's going on?
I guess not. Maybe after the second one, she was like, okay.
Yeah, definitely. Something's up.
Yeah, something's up. But let's just be cautious of who we, you know, date on these dating apps. Because you never really know somebody for real, for real. Like, you never gonna know somebody for real, for real. Especially on a dating app, because motherfuckers be lying about their names, about what they do.
They do.
Like, I know somebody who lies about what they do on dating apps. So...
Y'all watch out.
Women beware, you know. These men be crazy. It's women too, though. Women be crazy too.
Yeah.
Just it's in general.
Scary on day nap.
Yeah, because you never know what you're signing up for. Like, you never know what you're signing up for in real life either. But on dating apps, it's like damn near 10 times more harder because remember that? I don't remember her name, but it was a black girl and she was in the South and she met this white dude on a dating app and then she died. And they think the white man killed her because he was the last person to be with her. But I think he, like, you know, unmatched with her or whatever.
Yeah,
so it's like they can't trace it back to him, but...
He did it.
He definitely did that shit. So, y'all just be aware, you know, like, be aware. Also, I wanted to update on the Sergio Brown thing because it's been, like, a little series. He has been charged. Or he faces charges in his mother's murder. Like, they... arrested that nigga and I think they gonna charge him with first degree.
He killed that lady.
I think he killed that lady because it's like some of her belongings were missing or whatever, and then they ping like the location of like her phone or whatever and then it went back to his location. Yeah,
and then he went missing.
Yeah. Then, like, they noticed, like, blood on the patio of the home.
Oh,
and
over.
It matched his DNA.
It's over for him.
Yep. Then cameras in the area, they captured the offender burning items in a fire pit on the evening of September 14th. Yep. Yep. And then he booked the Uber to the fucking airport and flew to Mexico on the morning of September 15th. So, they saw, like, the camera shit on September 14th. On September 15th, he got the Uber to the airport, flew to Mexico, and then booked the Airbnb stuff with his mom's credit card.
What? Oh.
And he was carrying a bag of his mama's stuff when he was detained.
I really want to know. Now I just want to know, like, why he did it.
I blame it on CTE. I think that's, like, way more serious than people would like to admit. That's why my son will never play.
What the football's football. Like the
because you
did
can't
you watch even... that movie, that Will Smith movie.
No,
that's a good movie.
But like the whole like Aaron Hernandez thing, you
yeah,
remember him?
I heard of that too.
Yeah, like when he died, you know, they did a scan of his brain or whatever, and that nigga had CTE. That's one of those things where like they can't even diagnose you with it for real until you're dead. So it's like, my son, you're not playing football. I'm so sorry, boo boo. Better kick that soccer ball.
It's too much head on, like,
yeah, like too much head on collision, like the tackling, all that, like, that's
multiple
just a very
times, like every game,
yeah, like you leave every game concussed. Like, who wants to live like that?
That's scary.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. I keep fucking with this mic because I just want to, like,
oh yeah,
all I have to do is can I do it? Did I do anything?
I don't think so.
It didn't.
It did. Yeah,
because I wanted to, like, I don't know. I'm gonna just leave.
Like,
it alone.
Be at a like a like lower.
Like, I wanted to be like in my face, but I think it's like how it's like clipped on the thing. Cause like, it's like a weird angle.
Cause I tried to adjust mine a little bit, and it was just like, yeah. That's why I just scooted up.
Cause... Yeah. All right. I'll leave it alone. Okay.
So we got the current news out the way. Any songs you're listening to lately? New songs or anything?
On the ride here, I was bumping "Walk It Out" by Jennifer Hudson. Okay. Yeah. It randomly came on my little station on Apple Music. And I'm like, damn, like when I was younger, when that song first came out, I really fucked with that song.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like,
it's always good to find old songs.
Yes.
Cause like, I had listened, like, OMG had played
about
OMG
Usher?
With Usher. Yeah. And I was like, oh,
okay. Period.
Usher went dumb.
He went stupid. He went dumb. My gosh. But like, new, I don't really.
Yeah, like, I don't. I'm just trying to see. It's usually like, what's new to me is usually be like old albums. And then like, I didn't listen to the song. Yeah, that's mainly what it is. Same.
But I'm not gonna lie, I listened to Offset album.
Was that good?
It was cute. I think, excuse me, my favorite song off of there would be Princess Cut with Chloe.
See, everybody was talking about that. I haven't listened to it yet.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to.
That's that shit. When I finally start back up my Wits Tune of the Week shit, I'm gonna put that on there because. Yeah, I'll be bumping that shit. And Barbie by Jaden Alexis. You know what? I don't like this song because it's lyrical, because it's not lyrical. It's far that sample. From it. I'm a bad little bitch and I'm shaped like a Barbie. It's the beat. Yeah, it's the sample. It's that, the beat.
That, what is that? Shake That Monkey, ain't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's all right. Yeah.
I be.
Oh my god.
Me and my boyfriend, like, we love that fucking song. And the song is so stupid. She talking about this my dick. Like girl,
all right.
And I know he wrote that. So I'm like, how does it feel to write all of that?
Yes, he did. He definitely did.
Because as soon as the song is over, like if you look at the lyrics, it's like written by Jonathan Porter. So yeah, I don't like the song, but it's lyrical. It's just catchy.
Get that one lyric together. She just could not get it together. Like,
he was on his what was that nigga name?
He was on his Lucian shit.
Thank you. Yes. Yes. When that nigga was on Hustle and Flow, oh, he was like, push that shit out.
No, literally, like,
yes, he on hit that shit.
Oh my god,
that's my shit though, for real. And she not built like a Barbie. That's the crazy part. But yeah, you know, I don't body shame.
Yeah,
but I'm not built like a Barbie either, but
yeah. But
when the song come on, I am. It's ass in a Cardi. Period. Hello, motherfucker. He know how to make some shit go viral. She just got a record deal.
He do.
Did you know that she signed to Columbia?
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Shows you where the music industry is. Who these days. On there? I think Beyonce.
Really.
I think she got like her own little label within Columbia Parkwood.
My goodness.
Yeah. I'm like, oh.
Ain't no telling what else she gonna put out now then.
I feel like she probably signed a 360 deal. Somebody on Twitter was like, she ain't signed a 360 deal, she signed a 720. But shout out to her. You know, we love women succeed, but you know.
Now she married and well, she a fiance, so
I feel like he did that to spite his mama.
Oh, for sure.
But that's none of my business. But yeah,
they got something weird going on. I don't know.
Him and his mama.
His mama just the typical, like, I love my son.
I don't think his mama. I don't know. She's just mom at all.
No, she's not a good mom, but she just be so obsessed. And I just be like,
was like, you didn't even really raise us, blah 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 blah. And she don't give me the impression that she raised her kids. For one, and for two, Blueface hate his mama, so I'm like, why are you so obsessed with him? He don't even like you.
I don't know.
That's her meal ticket though.
Yeah. It is.
The only reason why she got any kind of clout is because of him. They got this fake ass reality show.
Wait, I did watch some of that. I'm not gonna lie.
The mama show? The mama reality? Hell That's no. what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Girl, I thought you was talking about
Krishan and Blueface.
Yeah.
You're funny as a bitch.
Sadly.
We all love trashy TV sometimes.
Yeah. It's good entertainment, like just to watch.
Yeah. Mind numbing shit. Don't have to think. You can just.
Literally.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to dig deep in this episode.
Yeah. We're going to get to the root of why these men be tripping. This episode is titled Girl. Why he tripping?
Why is he tripping?
Like, why is he tripping?
We really finna get to the nitty gritty.
Let's get to the bottom of it.
Wow. So, where do we start? I have misogyny on mine. That's the first starter.
Oh, for me, it's the Madonna horror complex.
Hey. I can scroll right down and we can get right on there.
Okay. You want to?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. So, the Madonna horror complex was first identified by Sigmund Freud. Is it Freud or Freud?
I feel like it's Freud. Sigmund Freud.
I'm going to just call him Sigmund. But y'all know who I'm talking about, but I won't be referring to him by his last name. And it's the inability to maintain sexual arousal within a committed, loving relationship. This develops in straight men, where they place women in two categories. Like, you have the Madonna, and that's like the woman that is nurturing and pure, and then you have the whore, and that's the woman that is promiscuous and just over sexual. Like, think Jezebel, you know, think like that. So men, basically, like, what the Madonna whore complex is, it says that men love the Madonna, but they desire the whore. Mm. And Sigmund said, where such men love, they have no desire, and where they desire, they cannot love.
Mm.
Yeah. I talked to my mom about this, and she was like, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really, once you, realize what it is, it's really an eye-opener.
Mm-hmm. It pushes it into perspective.
It do.
Yeah. Because men always be like, we don't love these hoes, but they want the hoe.
And it is like, you see all this, lyrics, oh, I want a lady in the streets with a freaking a bed.
But let that woman really be a freak in a bed, and you'll be, the men be like, who else have you done?
Yeah. Let her be adventurous and experimental. All of a sudden, it's, who else was it?
Yeah. Like, they want you to basically be a virgin. I think this whole complex is like,
I think it's terrible.
I think it's very terrible. It I think it's like, go. Damn near like pedophilic. Like, I don't it, even think I'll use right. Word for
it's
that,
just
but.
So like anybody that you meet is like they've lived a life,
yeah, at this age
they lived a sexual life, like, yeah. It's just like, why are we so focused on that? I let you live, why couldn't I?
Yeah. And it's like, okay, say my body count is over a number that you think is high. One, if we weren't dating, you wouldn't care. If you were just trying to have sex with me, you would still have sex with me.
Exactly.
So now, why when we're dating, like, why isn't an issue?
Now it just, I don't know.
Yeah.
And honestly, like, in my opinion, I don't like answering this question.
I hate it.
Honestly, I only want to know for shits and giggles, you know? Like, I like knowing about, you know, to a T. Because don't tell me too much, but like, I feel like that's a part of like a relationship. Like, yeah, like we should be able to feel comfortable telling each other about our past, you know, sexual experiences, if it was crazy or that's why I want to know. Like,
yeah. I want to know the funny shit.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I want to know the funny stuff. Like, but yeah, don't you turn around and judge me.
Yeah. Because the men, their body counts be literally like double, triple. And we're not judging them. So not why are judging. You judging us? You
not
know?
Judging like, at all, honestly. Because, and it's not even, and that's the thing too, like, I was having that conversation too, like, it's not even that I expect men body counts to be double or triple, mm-hmm. but like, whatever you tell me, okay.
Okay. Because like, when, like, because
what am
you,
I going to do?
First of all, like, what can you even do about it? Like, what can he do about it at this point?
You're going to reverse time and not have sex with the people you've had sex with.
Like, be for real. Like, I think, I don't even believe in body counts for real. Because at my grown, big-ass age, like, I'm not counting how many partners I've, like, especially because I lost my virginity. I'm going to be very transparent. I lost my shit at, like, 16. So it's like,
and that's fine.
Yeah. So it's like, what are we even talking about right now? Like, because I'm finna be 24. Why am I still
we
thinking
lived
about
a
shit?
Life.
Yeah, like, I've lived a life, and like, why do I have to like relive the shit that I did when I was very inexperienced? To be honest, people I boned back in high school shouldn't even count. Shouldn't even count because it don't even matter. But men really be like, no, my girl, she gotta have three to four. And it's like, so you don't want a girl with a nice portfolio? You don't want, you know, like, let's think about it like you're hiring, you know, somebody for a position. You don't want the person with the most experience.
And it's just like, yeah. And honestly, like, hey, shout out to the women that, you know, three or four. You go.
Yeah, I love
you
that. You go, girl. I love that for you.
You go.
One thing about me.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I mean, it's just like, even, I just don't. It's just stressing me out.
It be stressing me out, too.
Like, oh my gosh. Like, why is that such a...
But, like, the killer for me and, like, what, like, really ties into the Madonna whore complex is that the men, they will have this, like, they're perfect girl. She don't have all these bodies. She's so pure. She cooks. She clean. Mm-hmm. And then they'll still go cheat on her with, guess what? A woman that probably has countless bodies. They don't give a freak because they still want to have sex with her. They desire her. They mm-hmm. lust after her. But they don't lust after the girl they got at home. And they cheating on, mm-hmm. but you wanted her so bad just because she's so pure. That is so weird to me. Like, because when I think of pure, I think of, like, kids, like babies.
Yeah.
Like, why do you want your woman
like,
to
be I'm
pure?
Thinking, like, one.
Yeah.
One body.
And, like, why would you want that? Like, I mean, like, if you or want that, you just, want that. But
that's
like,
what I'm saying. Like, even just in, like, and this goes into, like, rap lyrics and stuff, like, because I be hearing that, like, oh, well, she only ever did it with me, and it's like, ew.
But who have you done it with? Yeah. You've done it with the whole Milwaukee, whole Atlanta.
Ugh.
Yeah. And we don't, and my whole thing is, like, we don't judge men for this.
I don't. We don't.
All I want to know is if you're clean.
Yeah.
I promise you.
And I feel like that's the big end goal.
Yeah.
Safe sex. That's it.
Yeah, but like anything other than that, like body count and all that stuff, it literally does not matter because at the end of the day, you gonna fuck regardless. That's all I have to say.
That is true.
So it's like you're over here crying about this for what? Because I've had an ex cry to me about like I don't know what number I told him, but then I was like, oh no, like it's actually this. Oh my gosh, he was pissed. He was so pissed. I'm like, bro.
Like relax.
Yeah,
please.
Like chill out. Take a chill pill. Then we were still together after that. So it's like, you did all that for what? You did all that for what?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's just so weird to me. I don't like that at all.
It's a double standard.
It's a real big double standard.
Big double standards. They could just do whatever, and it's just like, oh, we were just waiting for y'all this whole entire time.
Like, no.
Yeah.
No.
I was living. Actually.
Literally. I am a grown ass woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like they don't be wanting us to, like, have agency over our bodies.
Yeah. I don't. And it's just like, because it just goes into, like, just like, oh, like, you know, how did this happen? How did it get to this number?
Yeah, and it's like, how do you think it got? Like, let's sit and, like, let's, like, really be for, like, how do you think it got to this number?
Especially, like, that's what I'm saying. Especially when you count from high school. That's why I'm like, I don't really count from high school. Like, I was young.
Yeah.
I was young. It really started in college. Let's just be real.
Period.
And, hey, us women, we know. We know when we want to have that sexual encounter with somebody. So yeah. It's just like.
And men hate that. Like, they hate when you know what you want. Like,
yeah.
And I'm like, why do I have to wait for you? Like, no, this is my coochie.
That's the thing, too. Like, even when, like, you talking to somebody, like, beforehand, you know, before pre, you know, we're both committed gals.
Period.
But, like, when you talking to somebody and you know they want sex and they try to play this, like, role to manipulate you into sex, and it's just like,
but you don't have to do that. I'm gonna stop you right there.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I'm gonna stop you right there.
Yeah,
and okay, we can do that. Now it's
whoa, it's too easy. Like, what are you talking about? It should be easy.
why you want a rat race?
Yeah,
to get
like
it?
Why do you
want
to chase me? You don't have to chase me.
But that thing. It's that thing. Like they just competitive, and I just don't. I'm not with that.
I'm not with that either.
I'm not gonna.
You like, especially because I'm like, my biggest thing be like, I'm grown.
Yeah, I'm not gonna play that game.
Yeah, like I'm not playing the game. You want to hump? I want to hump. Let's hump.
Let's do it.
Yeah, like you don't have to be calling me every day, you know, trying to act like you give a fuck about
that's what I'm saying. Don't
going on. Yeah, because you don't care that. In the long run, like you don't care. So let's just, you know, hit me up when you're ready, and I'll make sure
just,
I'm ready.
Yeah, that'll just be that.
Yeah.
I mean, hey,
or when I'm ready and I hit you up, pick up the phone.
You don't have to do this whole acting Mr. Nice Guy
act. Yeah.
Hey, you should be nice. Let's just say that, but you don't have to perform.
Yeah, I just...
Just be clear.
Yeah. And honestly, I feel like that comes from, like, the Madonna whore complex, too, mm-hmm. because, you know, like, if a man don't... I know for myself, like, people tell me all the time, like, men especially, I look so innocent. And so, I look so innocent. And so... I know that they probably enjoy the, like, trying to, like, break down my innocence and, like, you know,
man,
turn me into this.
Don't tell me that.
Yeah, but it's like, because when I think innocent, again, I think
child.
Of a child.
I think of a child. I think of a child just.
Yes, like, I think of a child.
Ew.
And like, I just feel like this whole complex within straight men, especially, like, y'all end up viewing women in sex. Like, mm-hmm. like we should be kids in some kind of way, and I think that it's just like so like low key like y'all are pedophiles, and I know like y'all probably don't want to hear that, but it's giving pedophile. Because why do you want me to be a virgin so bad? Like,
yeah,
that is so weird. Like,
it's very like
that's yeah. It's like why are you so obsessed with that? Like, then to just go and cheat on me anyway. That's just the crazy part. Like, find a whore you really like. And wife her up, and you'll be happy as hell. Hoes deserve love too.
That's what I'm saying. Even just this whore, hoe, like, how is she a hoe?
Okay, because she know what she want, and she is in control of her vagina, and you can't take that. So now she gotta be a whore, like, cause you're a whore. I be telling my brother this all the time. I be like, you're a whore. But let me tell him that, he'd be like, oh yeah, I'm a whore. Yeah, I'm a player, I'm a pimp.
It's like player is pimp. Yeah. Is, but women, it's,
oh, you slut.
Oh, you're a slut.
Yeah, you Jezebel. Oh, you shouldn't be doing, like, what are you talking about? Like, I want us to get rid of the double standard. That's what I want.
I do too, but honestly, it's just so, like,
it's so engraved in society.
It is, and it's very frustrating, like. Ugh.
But I just be like, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to live my life like it's golden. Shout out to Jill Scott.
Shout out to Jill.
Okay, Jilly from Philly. I'm going to live my life like it's golden. I'm not going to let no man tell me what I can and what I cannot do with my body. And if you don't like it, I'm just not the one for you. Per.
Hey.
But you'll probably never find a woman in this day and age who going to do exactly what you want them to do, like, in that kind of way.
Because
it's like... Women are getting smarter. Women are waking up. There are still some pick-me's like, ew, having over four bodies is disgusting. How can, like, girl, mind your own pussy. That's one thing I'll never do. I'll never mind somebody else's pussy.
Yeah.
Like, I'm never going to mind somebody else's business like that.
That's not my business.
Yeah.
You do what you do.
You do what you do. And more, like, hats off to you. More props to you. Like, you know, like, because it's your coochie.
At
so it's your business.
Day.
Yeah, and I want the men to remember that. Like, it's our coochie at the end of the day. So whoever we choose to give it to, however many times we decide to give it out, that's between us and our OBGYN. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
You ate that?
Purr.
Now, we did talk about Madonna horror complex.
Mm-hmm.
And that goes into, like... I feel like that goes into misogyny.
It does.
Yeah, it goes hand in hand.
Yeah.
What do I have? I have the definition.
Mm-hmm.
Involves punishing women for challenging male dominance, rooted in hatred for women, but it's not the same as sexism. As we know, sexism is the discrimination based on the belief that male sex is superior to the female sex.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I also have how to recognize it.
Mm-hmm.
Expressing hatred for women, catcalling or harassing women. I hate that.
I hate that too.
I hate it. Yeah. Hate it so much.
Like, don't talk to me, actually.
Don't, like, That's interesting.
Yeah. After the first A, leave it alone.
Yeah, please.
I can hear. I got ears. I'm not deaf.
It was one time where, I don't know where I was. It was one time where somebody was, like, trying to approach me, and I was like, no. I got called a bitch. Oh, I.
Fuck you too then, bitch.
Yeah, I'm a mess now because you. Oh.
Okay. Mm.
Interesting.
A little salty there, ain't you?
Yeah. They also have a strong belief in traditional gender roles. Let's break this.
I hate a gender role.
I hate a gender role so much.
Unless it's taking out the trash, like I said before.
See? Yeah.
Certain shit I just
like.
Won't do.
It's just like, I be saying that too, but like, when I'm at home, I do be taking out the trash. I ain't gonna lie.
Well, you also got a house full of women.
Yeah, it's then my dad, but like, yeah, he be at work sometimes, so
yeah,
just go ahead and do it. Yeah, but hey,
because yeah, your brother not really old enough yet.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, he definitely will be. also ignoring or speaking over women. Oh my gosh. Mm. Stealing ideas from women but refusing to credit them.
They basically just be hating on the women.
Yes.
Just real prejudice against the women.
Real.
And it's just like, this is a consequence of a male-dominated society.
Mm-hmm.
Because now men think that they shit don't stink and that they can just, you know.
Just above it all.
Yeah, like they're just above women and so much. And it's like, no, we're actually very equal. And sorry to break it to you, but without us, you would not be here.
Yeah. And it's just like so many things, like so many, like. So many things happen because of women. We just stand beside y'all.
Yeah.
Not getting the credit we deserve. We letting y'all have it. Some stuff, like, even back in the day, we let y'all have it. But, mm-mm.
Not anymore. I feel like...
Not anymore. Definitely not anymore.
Yeah.
It's definitely, like, more, you know, we getting out there. We doing what we need to do.
Period. As we fucking should. I didn't really even like think about misogyny like as a whole. I was just thinking of like specific shit because I got like toxic masculinity. Mm. Yeah.
Hey, that kind of, you know, because I also have like how to spot a misogynist male.
Oh, yeah, let's do that.
Okay. So I have, he objectifies women. He views women as objects whose job is to please men. He likes to rate women on a scale from 1 to 10, and he refers to women he finds unattractive in demeaning terms. He collects women. He views women as trophies he collects. His self-esteem is dependent on having a nice arm piece when he walks into a room. Mm. He needs validation, and he likes to rotate women and brag about it. He is scared of getting close or developing an emotional dependency, so he keeps a rotation. You're not a player. You just have emotional problems.
I hate that. I hate when men think that they're players anyway. Because why do you want to be a player?
Why do you want to... Yeah, I don't... Why do you want to rotate women and hurt women's feelings?
My brother got that real bad.
It's a disgusting trait.
His whole persona is Hugh Hefner. Like, he's Hugh Hefner, ew, like, reincarnated. Yeah. I'm like, bro, you're disgusting. Like... I'm not gonna say this because that's my brother, but it's just like, why do you
but
think
stop
like
this
that?
Yeah, yeah, like, it's just more so like, stop that. Like,
and honestly, he hates me for this, but anytime a girl asks me like, so about your brother, I'm like, what about him? I'm like girl, you should go. Get out of here. I'm like, get out of here. Like,
they
it's
be,
not
they be like, oh,
they be ignoring me.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then they'll tell him like, oh yeah, she said I should. Yeah, girl.
Yeah.
I wasn't telling you so that you go back and tell him. I'm telling you so that you'll jingle.
Okay.
Leave.
Like, so you can really think about this.
Yeah. Because I'm really like a girl. Like, when it comes to the men, I'm really a girl's girl. Even when I have been cheated on, I still be like, no, the girl. You know, I mostly blame the man unless the girl.
Honestly, that's
like,
what I'm saying. Like,
too tough.
Yeah.
Like, all right, bitch.
Because most of the time, it do be, it be the man.
Yeah.
It do.
Yeah.
And I don't like, and I don't be liking that. Like, whenever I be seeing, like, even videos and stuff, and they be like, well, blah, blah, that bitch. But
I hate that because it's like you're doing all of this over him, over little Timmy. Little Timmy playing both of y'all.
Little Timmy getting his way. He had his cake and eat it too.
And eat it too. Like, I'll never forget this girl gonna DM me like, oh, like, you can have them. And I'm like, girl, like, what are you talking about?
I don't want them.
I'm over here trying to, like, be like, girl, I didn't even know y'all was together. Yeah. Like, I didn't even know y'all had two more kids. Like, I didn't even know Baze. And she's, like, not trying to hear it. I'm like, girl, you deserve better. Like, I'm not fucking with him no more. I don't think you take should fuck with him. Yeah, like, I don't think you should fuck with him anymore.
If this is, if and that's what I'm saying, like, she coming to you, ain't no telling how many people she done said you can have them to.
And it's like, why do you want to keep putting yourself through that? Like,
you deserve better, babe.
We really, women as a whole, like, we enable men to act this way because for some goddamn reason, we be too scared to just step up. Mm-hmm. And you know what? I will admit it. When my ex cheated on me, I did stay. I did cuss a bitch out or two. It was giving very much, girl. It was giving very much. Girl, wake up. But I will say, with both of the girls that I ended up, like, going back and forth with, it was just like, I came, like, I approached them very nicely, and then they took it there, so I took it there. But it's like, after the first one, I should have been like, girl, you should go.
Yeah.
Because that only, like, me not leaving at that time, that only enabled him and, like, damn near empowered him.
Like, damn, I can my way.
Yeah.
I can ice
skate. I'm having my way.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. Fuck no. Stop letting these men have their way. Because they will, and they'll have their way all over you.
They're going to do it again. They're just going to do it again without you knowing.
Without you knowing. And I wouldn't have known if I did not go through his phone.
Man.
I just saw a tweet today that was like, do you go through phones? And I'm like, yeah, I do.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, like... Like...
With my current boyfriend, I have not went through his phone. Mm-hmm. But that's because, like, he don't give me the vibe
you trust
that
him.
I should. Yeah.
You trust him, like, you don't have no... It's not raising no hairs, like...
Yeah. Like, I only go through your phone once you give me a reason not to trust you. Yeah. But that's stupid of me, because once you give me a reason not to trust you, I should just go.
Yeah. It but then you kind of want to... It's almost like you kind of want a reason to just, like... You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to see it.
I'm not kind of person. Like, I have to get my feelings hurt in order for me to be like, all right. Like,
this the last straw.
Yeah. Because I was like... Me and my ex was living together. I was crawling on the floor military style at night while he sleeps. Yes. Crawling on the floor military style while he sleeps to get his phone. I would drag it. I would just drag it down from the nightstand, put it on the floor, and then crawl back to my side of the room.
You had no business doing
that. No business doing that. Then I would go to the bathroom and lock the door. But it's just like, once you have to go that far.
Oh my God.
Once you have to go that far, just leave it alone. And it was like, I would send, like, locations that he would be at all the time to my phone. I would send screenshots of messages to him. Like, and it's just like, he probably knew I was doing this, and he just didn't give a fuck because I wasn't leaving.
Yeah.
So once again, like,
whatever.
Literally, so once again, we be enabling them. We have to stop enabling them.
We do.
Mm-hmm.
What else do I have? He has a bad relationship with significant women in his life. His mother, sister, grandmother are significant women in his life. Like I said, the unresolved feelings that come with the painful relationships can result in an anger towards women that gets played out in romantic relationships and general feelings toward the entire gender. Some of these men be having mother issues. Or grandmama issues.
I always be like, damn, like, did his mama not hug him tight enough as a kid? Like, because why do you look at women this way?
Yeah.
Like, and not all women are the same. Like, I'm sorry your mama didn't fuck with you.
I be hating that too.
But don't take
it's kind of like, or even just like, you had a past relationship, you know what I'm saying? She hurt you bad. And then you projecting on me.
Yeah, that'd be annoying me because I'm like, I'm not her.
Yeah, like, start off
I'm not
fresh.
Her. Yeah, like, because I start every relationship off. I start every talking situation fresh. Off fresh. Yes. Yeah, like, I'm not finna be, because
like,
I done
just
got my
imagine,
heart broke.
That's what I'm saying. Just imagine if you put all that hurt and anger on somebody else in the
they
next
wouldn't
one.
Be able to take it.
No,
but I feel like they be wanting us to like low key like
therapy
them over.
Session too.
They do be trying to use us as therapy.
Win them mine. Over
I'm
as
not
well.
Your therapist. Yeah, I'm not your therapist.
That's, you gotta, yeah.
Yeah, you mm-mm. gotta go talk to the lady, and I'm not the
I
lady.
Can only talk to you about certain things. But
yeah, and then it's like...
this is getting deeper.
Yeah, and it's like, yeah. you have some stuff you need to work on with somebody who's licensed mm-hmm. to help you work on this. I can't... like, you can tell me about it. Of course, I'm not... I'm never gonna tell you, don't, like...
right.
Don't talk to me about nothing, but... don't come to me expecting therapy because I don't get paid to listen to your problems.
Then I can only
and I can only
so
tell
much.
You so much.
Yeah, I can only do so much. So it's like,
yeah,
this is sounding like it's getting into childhood
because it'd be like deep rooted.
Yeah, stuff. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. yeah,
and it's like you need to go see the lady because mm-hmm. I like. It's not that I don't get paid to listen to your problems. It's just like
you can't.
I be having a lot yeah. going on myself, so mm-hmm. it's like. I can literally only listen to you and give you info from, like, what I think.
Right.
But who the fuck am I? A bitch with a podcast?
You got no idea, bro. Please. But no, seriously, like, what can I do?
Yeah, like, what can I do for real?
Because this is, yeah.
And you know what? That is a really great point because... we need more men, especially black men, in mm-hmm. therapy. I mm-hmm. don't know why y'all think therapy is just, like, not good for you. Like, my dad, mm-hmm. he used to say, like, because when I first started going to therapy in, like, 2019, early 2020, he's like, you know, you going and you telling this girl all this stuff, and then when she get off, she want to go and kill herself. And I'm like... Why did it
have to get to that
point? Why
did
it have to get to that point? And it's also like, okay, that's our business. But yeah. when we in our session, she's actually helping me
right.
become a better person and grow as a person.
And I mean, hey, she got to get some therapy for her shit, too.
Everybody needs therapy.
Yeah.
You know, like, in this day and age, like, I think everybody needs therapy. You mm-hmm. could think that you had the most perfect childhood growing up. But I guarantee you,
there's you start looking into yeah, the behavior.
Yeah, you really start like picking through it with like a fine tooth comb, and you like, oh, yeah. So, black men, y'all gotta go see the lady,
especially too. Like, even with their, you know, them going to therapy, like it's they got a higher like suicidal rate. Like, even that woman, that was on Ellen dancing.
Oh, yeah, Twitch.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I was like, goodness.
But that, excuse me. Oh, no, it didn't come out. Excuse me. That plays into toxic masculinity.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, like, there's three traits of toxic masculinity. There's, like, toughness. So, like, men are strong, aggressive, and emotionally hardened. Mm-hmm. Anti-femininity. Men reject all feminine traits. They don't ask for help. They don't want to be domestic. And then power. Like, men are only worthy if they have money, status, influence. So it's like the three traits, main traits of toxic masculinity. And the toughness one, like, them having to be, quote-unquote, emotionally hardened. Mm-hmm. You don't have to do that. Like, it's perfectly okay to cry. It's perfectly okay
to
feel things.
You're not a robot.
Yeah, like, we're humans. Like, we have emotions. Like, it's okay. Like, I just want black men to know, or men in general, like, it is okay. Like, you don't have to deal with your shit in private and silence.
Yeah, like, you don't have to keep it bottled up.
Yeah. Because you're not hurting anybody but yourself. So, and why do you want to hurt yourself? Like, do you hate yourself? That's something you should work out in therapy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Deep like, through that.
It is okay to feel stuff. I hate when men feel like emotions are gay.
I hate that too.
Yeah. Because it's like, you don't think your dad be crying? I remember I only saw my dad cry once. And mm-hmm. he didn't even let me see him cry. He went to somebody's house. And he left me in the car to go cry. Gosh. Yeah, this was after... one of his brothers had died, and he went to his sister's house, and he left me in the car.
Cry. That's
to go
the thing.
Cry. Yeah,
that's something you cry about. Like,
yeah, like, good thing I'm not a boy, and because if I was a boy, I could have took that out.
Oh, for sure.
I can't let nobody see me cry. But it's just like, I wish my dad would have felt comfortable enough to be vulnerable like that around me, because it's like, I need to see that. You know, like, I need to see a good example of a man who can, you know, take charge of his emotions and, like, you know, feel his emotions. Like, I think everybody needs to see that. We need positive representation, because that could lead me to choose a man who don't know how to express his emotions, because, oh, this is how my daddy was. My daddy was tough. Like, no.
Unemotional.
Yeah, yeah, like, everybody has emotions. Everybody feels things. Let's make it okay for men to express them. Yeah.
And it's not a fun time talking to emotionally unavailable men.
It's not at
all. It's not a fun time. It's like you almost like just like pulling, trying to pull it out of him. And it's just like,
it's too much work. Like, cause you be draining yourself trying to pull stuff from him. So leave that emotionally unavailable man where he at. He should be unavailable across the board.
By himself.
Yeah. Cause until you work that out, you shouldn't be with nobody. You shouldn't even talk to nobody. Cause I make you mad. What you gonna do? You gonna spaz out on me?
Yeah.
Because you've been holding in all this stuff. And so now I did one little thing, like drop a fork and you was gonna eat off that fork. And now you punching me in the face.
Yeah. Scary.
Yeah. Like that's crazy. But that's like, that's how far it goes. Especially with all this domestic violence going on. Like, I feel like most of the time when men are taking their emotions out on women, it's because
it's the upbringing.
Yeah. Yeah. And also, like, they take it out on us because they can't take it out on nobody else.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's kind of like, why would you even want to, like, that goes back to the misogyny thing. Like, I feel like they probably think, oh, they can take it, you know. Like, no, we can't take it, actually. No. We shouldn't have to take it, actually. Like, if you would just go sit and talk to somebody, it wouldn't even get this deep.
Honestly.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because, you know, like, as kids, men are taught to suck things up or, like, take it like a man or something. Or if they're, like, going through like a tough time.
Those responses, yeah.
Like, those really matter. And I be trying to instill that in people, like, it's okay. I was watching Real Housewives of Atlanta last night or yesterday. And Phaedra, when she had her son Apollo. What's his name?
Yep.
His name was Apollo, right? No, Apollo was her husband. What was her son's name? Aiden.
Yeah.
When she had Aiden, the baby was crying because he wanted to be in his mama's arms. This is a fucking baby. And the dad is like, no, make him sit in his chair, blah, blah, blah. That's where it starts. Let that baby be held. Babies are meant to be held.
And it's just like, the baby can't communicate with words, so of course they're gonna cry.
Of course.
That's the only way they can
communicate.
Express
themselves. Yeah, so it's like, why, like, let your babies cry. Especially your boy babies. Like, let them cry. It's okay. He don't, like, he's not a man.
Yeah.
So, what you mean take it like a man? That's a fucking child. Like, let's...
It's insane. It goes, yeah, it goes back. Even that one thing. I hate bringing her up. Krishan. Oh my gosh.
I was thinking of that.
With
when she was like, I gotta be a man in a
mama.
Yeah, I'm gonna dress like a because you know, I don't want him to be feminine talking with his hands. Like, you don't have a fucking tooth. I think we should start there. Your priorities are all fucked up for one.
Oh, and
your
mentality is wearing a hospital band.
And you had him how long ago?
Just put it in the scrapbook.
Talking about
even Carisha, she has some tweets too about like she something about she gonna kick her if her son come out gay or whatever, she gonna kick him out or whatever.
I'm
but
like,
you,
your best friends with Saucy Santana,
that and you be on your show like queer baiting, like
that is true.
She do
because girl, you're not gay for real. I can't even picture you eating nobody coochie.
So it's like, oh
yeah,
okay,
like, so it's okay for you to do it. But and yeah, like, that's when like women really we like as a whole, we do play a part in how these men be thinking, because once again,
we do,
we the act like we it's all right saying, for them to think like that. Yeah, because what you mean you'll kick your son out if he gay?
What
you mean by that? like he's still your son, he just like men,
right?
What's wrong with that?
I mean, you can't control his sexuality, whatever.
Or even like when the niggas be on Twitter and they be like gay son or
daughter. Oh my gosh, why was I thinking that? What was that just in my head? It kept like, what do you mean?
Like, first of all, why are you even projecting onto your unborn children?
Yeah,
like this?
And what's the two you have to choose from? What is that?
Yeah. So what if my daughter is a quote-unquote thought? I love my daughter, and this is my daughter. So what if my son is gay?
Okay.
This is my son, okay? I don't have to hump him.
Right, moving on. Like,
yeah, like...
It's just so like...
It really be pissing me off because I just want men to realize, like, it is okay if... the man standing right next to you does not fit into your box of what manhood is, because womanhood and manhood, masculinity, femininity, those are spectrums. Like, not everybody is going to be a man the same way. Not everybody is going to be a woman the same way. Like, we have to stop trying to fit people into these boxes, because to be honest, people don't belong in boxes. Like, we...
Like,
people should be
checklist?
Able to be free. Yeah, like people should be checklist? Able to be free to be who they are. Like, be who you are for your pride. Not even if you're like, not even gay pride, you know, just like in general. Like, be who you
this
are.
Is your life. Yeah, this is your life. Like, you should live it how you want.
Period.
It's so many people where they be like, just even with the, like, they're gay and they're just like, oh no, I'm straight. And then you're hiding your true identity.
And that's when I be feeling like these men hate themselves. Because if you really loved yourself, you would want to be who you are.
Be free.
Like, you wouldn't want to have to act all tough and stuff when you know you're not even like that for real. And that's okay. Like, you don't have to be tough.
Even like the whole, like, even like gay men in general, when they be like, they just think they're not like a man, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, straight men think like gay men just
aren't men. And I'm like,
where does that come from?
Like they're still a man.
Yeah.
And truth be told, if they, you know, the gay man be knowing how to fight.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking. Like, it's just like they're still same gender as you. So.
Yeah. So like, just cause they like it in the booty or they like to put it in the booty, it don't matter.
It's okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Like they're still a man.
They're going to beat your ass.
Yeah. So maybe you should watch how you're talking. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I didn't even think of that. Cause they really do not be thinking that gay men are like men. And I'm.
Yes. And half of that stuff they be saying, it just be like, I think you're projecting.
I hate the whole like sissy thing. Like, and now I'm even kind of starting to hate sassy because, okay, I'm not gonna lie, sometimes men do be having a little attitude.
I was thinking that too.
But that's okay.
I'm starting to not like that either, because it's going into like how women call, like, it's even damaging, like men, like women calling like certain things that men do gay. Like,
yeah, and it's like,
because we all have feminine
and masculine traits.
Like,
so
it's like, yeah, the whole sassy thing is getting out of hand.
It's getting way out of hand. Like,
at first it was funny.
At first it was a little hee hee ha ha.
Yeah, but now it's like,
yeah. Cause I'm not gonna lie, a man going back and forth with a woman, sometimes I'd be like, okay, like, you taking a little too far.
Yeah.
Like, now you getting a little bit sassy.
Now you doing a little too much.
Yeah, like, maybe you just shouldn't. But
I'm just trying to
trying to like erase the sassy word out of my vocabulary, to be honest, because as you said, like, it's really starting to turn into gay. That's like another word for gay.
It is.
And gay is okay. I just want that to be known. Like, gay is okay. But like, calling a man sassy / gay because he get his nails painted, to me that's crazy.
Yeah.
Because it's fucking nail polish. And my dad used to get manicures. He wouldn't get, like, you know, color polish, but he'll get a cute little clear coat. Yeah, and I feel like that just means he likes to, like, take care of himself.
Like, what is wrong with that?
Yeah, a cute little pedicure so his feet not barking.
Okay.
You know, like, and that just means you care about yourself.
Some terrible toes.
Some toes, baby.
I've seen some bunions, funions.
Missing nails.
And then y'all got the nerve to be wearing open-toe sandals.
Like, my dad always said, if your feet don't look ready for other people to see, don't have your feet out. And you know what? That goes for men and women. For real, he used to be like, if your feet are not done, do not have your toes out. And you're right. Because you couldn't really catch my dad without a pedicure. He, and a manicure, he stayed on it. Like,
it's all about self-care. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Because you wouldn't call getting your hair cut gay. Okay. So why is taking care of your hands that you might be putting inside of a woman later?
Hygiene. Yeah.
Yeah. let's be for real.
And
like
you done touched the blunt, you done touched the bag of Cheetos.
Okay.
And then you
got all this shit underneath your fingernails because they too long. And you trying to put that inside of me. Go get a manicure. I don't know when manicures were like became a female only type of thing. But everybody should feel empowered to get a manicure.
They're doing the same thing. They're filing, they're cutting.
Yeah. They're just like keeping you clean. It's hygiene. Like you said, like you should want your hygiene to be together. But I think that social media like contributes to all of this because men, like they often feel like I said before, like they have to act a certain way, or like the men who don't conform to the expectations that society has or social media has, they get bullied. Like,
excuse me. My god!
I just saw this post on Facebook.
The picture with the
tutu. Yes. Why we got the same mind,
bro?
Niggas on Facebook and Twitter, they're mad as a bitch talking
like
about.
He got a family. If his daughter wanted to dress in a tutu and then she was like, oh, dad, why don't you wear one? It's for a photo.
Literally.
He not wearing it all day. And even if he wanted to.
Like, it's a tutu.
You not putting it on.
Okay. Like, so why do you care? Like, my whole thing is, okay, you won't do that for your daughter.
Right.
Fine. She's going to remember that. So I just want you to keep that in your mind. Oh, but like, you don't have to judge him. For
so
doing
many people
that.
Having think pieces on it. Oh my god!
Niggas talking about I'll do anything for my daughter, but wear a skirt. Wearing a skirt is where you draw the line. It's gonna kill you to put a tutu on
for a photo. That's
for
it.
A photo.
It's a fun theme.
Yeah, she, like and the like, daughter will always remember my dad
did that for me.
Yeah, like even when Young Thug was, he had that album cover with the dress on.
Yes, I didn't see anything wrong with it.
Me either.
He's expressive.
And honestly, it's fashion.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's fashion and it's like.
And we all know Young Thug get bitches. And even if he didn't get bitches, like what if Young Thug was gay? Who cares? You're not fucking him.
You're still streaming his music.
The way these men be like giving things, even women, the way they be giving think pieces, you would think that they're personally affected by what people be wearing.
Yes.
Let that man wear a skirt.
Like, it's okay.
Let that man wear a crop top.
Even with NBA Youngboy, when he, like, you know, came out of prison and he was, like, wearing, like...
the black nail polish?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he got cloned.
But Drake, he be having polish on his nails. Yeah. You don't really
no
see
No one
people.
Says anything.
Because it's Drake. People get passes.
Interesting.
Yeah, let's keep that same. Well, actually, don't keep the same energy. But if you're gonna judge one person, judge them all. Yep. Don't be selective with your outrage, because either nail polish is okay or it's not okay. Choose one. It should really be okay, but you can't straddle the fence, like, because that's just weird. Because now I think you're just hating.
And Drake getting real misogynistic too. Hate to see it, honestly. All these men I've been seeing, like even the gamers, like just like, oh my gosh,
bro,
it's scary. Oh my gosh,
when Kai Cenat, when he had the fake Zendaya,
oh my gosh, and the dude, he called, click it. What happened,
bro? Kai Cenat, he had a fake Zendaya. I don't like him either, actually.
Yeah, strong dislike for him.
He's very much like the average 20 to 28-year-old male in a person, and it's just like
it's damaging too. Like
it's so damaging to the kids, because kids are the people that watch him. He had a fake like a Zendaya lookalike or whatever, and he pranked his friend and had her talking to him for a little bit, and then like the friend realized, oh, like this is Zendaya, and then he just was like, ew, like she's ugly as fuck, and she looks like Zendaya.
I seen that she did.
So.
And he is too, isn't that that Aiden boy?
Mm-hmm.
Ugh, I don't. I will say I hate. I hate him.
I hate that brand of streaming. I hate that whole like brand of streamers. Like I group Andrew Tate into that category.
Yeah.
Low key, I group Kevin Samuels into that category. Like that's just nasty, because it's like that's real damaging. To kids, because kids are the main people who be listening to this stuff.
I just seen this video. Icy son. I guess he was streaming.
Got a son?
Yes, he got a son, girl. I just seen it on Twitter. Yes, he got a son. He on Twitch.
What he saying?
He was like, I don't know. He was at like a friend hangout. He ended up cutting this girl hair like on like live streaming. And she, you know how like she laughed it off, but I believe like she was shocked.
I would have been shocked as
And that goes deep into like you,
misogynistic as fuck, because you're getting off intentionally on the embarrassment of this girl.
Definitely. That's embarrassing. It's evil too, because so you cutting evil. Her hair, like she had in like, you know, like a nice hairstyle, like
it so was, she didn't expect it to get cut.
No,
down. Yeah,
like it was, you know what I'm saying, like it just bothers me.
Yeah,
you cut that, like you like demeaning her, like you just don't. You cut off something that it's just, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you cut off her hair, like, you know how much it could, like, mean to her. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? You kind of did that as a,
for a crowd.
Yeah.
And you know what? I feel like sometimes men only care about pleasing and, like, I can't think of the word, but they only care about pleasing other men.
The gaze of other men, yeah.
Yeah, like that's all they care about. Like, they don't give a hell about what we have. Yeah, that's, yeah, they only want the approval of other men. They don't care about what we have to say, what input we have. And it's just like, I get that we are a male-dominated society. I get that we're a patriarchy, of course. Of course, cool. But don't you think that's a little weird?
It even goes deep. That's what, like, right when you said that, it goes into, like, your friends have an opinion on your, you know, a person you're talking to. And then all of a sudden, you
want to push back. Ooh, I hate that. Because do you not have a brain of your own? Who cares what they have to say? This is your girl.
It gets weird like that. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and then I don't want nobody where somebody could, or not even like that, but mm-hmm. they'll be like, I don't want nobody where somebody else could say they had it, or somebody else that I might know, that we not friends or nothing, but I know him. I don't want him to be able to be like, oh, I had her.
What?
That's so childish.
So childish, and like,
it's just weird.
Y'all play
because who you humping him together. Or him or
yeah
her.
Y'all play basketball together one time and all of a sudden y'all best bud.
Yeah, like
interesting.
Yeah, that's also, like, I hate women are like, and this plays in like the anti-femininity part, like they feel like all feminine traits are just like bad. Yeah. Like, you don't want to, and to me, cooking and cleaning, that's not even a feminine trait. That's just, I know how to take care of myself trait. So why do you think cleaning your room or cleaning the kitchen every once in a while, like, why do you think that's feminine? Why is that a woman's thing to do?
Yeah, everyone should be able to do that for themselves.
Yeah. Like, let's stop that.
Yeah.
That's really fucking weird. Even like men only thinking like they have to like be big or whatever, like to be worthy, like they have to have some, like they have to have like a lot of money in order to be worthy. Yeah. Or like them having a lot of money, all of a sudden we should look at them like they're just a god.
It goes into that insecure.
I don't care if you have $1 million, nigga. If I don't want to be with you, I don't want to be with you. Like, yeah, what?
It's not gonna change anything.
Yeah, like I was I won't even say I was talking. I was trying to talk. Went on a date with this guy, you know. He, mutual friend of a close friend of mine. Mm-hmm. And he has a cool little position, you know, a little position of power, you know. And I just, on the date, y'all, I realized that he was talking about and about, like, the kind of like position of power he's in, or like even not on a date, when we were just hanging out with my mutual, like with our mutual friend and like other friends, he just kept talking about himself. And it's like, damn, nigga, like, do you give a fuck about me? You trying to pursue me? Like, do you care about me, or do you just want me to be like, oh, you're so awesome, we should be together? Just no. you gotta have a personality too. I don't know. And he's cool, but it's like I wouldn't want to date you because
you, yeah, you don't give me time to talk.
Yeah, and it's like I don't care about whatever you got going on. I'm not on a date with you for that. The fuck?
Ooh.
Yeah, I could find another you in a minute. Like I just wanted to get to know you.
Yeah,
and it's now like now that I'm cool. Yeah, like now that I know how you are, like we can be cool, Bookie. But that's about it. Or even like. You know, because we've both had this said to us before. Oh, we can't be friends because I want to hump you. What? What? Like, to me, that's a little toxic because especially if we were like already cool before you decided you wanted to hump me or like before I knew for real that you wanted to hump me. If we were already cool, why? And you know I'm not on that with you. It's okay to like not want to be my friend, but we can't be friends because just because you want to have sex with me, it's never gonna happen.
And then like that, and it's just like sometimes like, okay, like if you like, hey, you're cool, all of this, what's stopping you from just like you have to hunt me?
Yeah, like we can't just be cool.
Yeah, like it's either do or down. Like yeah, why
like,
is that
why is there not a third option?
Yeah, why is that the cool? Middle ground? Like why can't be no. I never understood that,
and I actually like that really like puzzles me.
Yeah, it kind of it gives me the ick too because it's just like ew.
Yeah, and then it's like when people be like, oh, he ain't wrong. What you mean?
What do you mean? Because
that to me, it makes me feel like you only see me as a piece of
meat. Yeah.
Like you don't see me as a person.
For sure.
You literally only have your eyes on me because you want to fuck me.
That's it. Like none of my personality. Yeah. None of that matters.
Yeah. Because I had the person said to me, he was like, you cool. Like you funny, but we can't be cool because I want to have sex with you.
And it's just like you saying that, like, I just feel like you don't think about how that affects me.
Me.
Yeah.
Like how that makes me feel.
Yeah. Like it makes me feel like, especially like dealing with just like, you know what I'm saying? Men in general, like just only wanting you for your body
your general.
It's just like, damn, like you think that way.
And like it's kind of like heartbreaking because I know the person said it to me, I really like actually viewed him as a friend and I'm like, damn.
Yeah, like
this is how you see me?
Goodness.
Goddamn.
Like
yeah.
If I said no, like just leave it. Like
yeah, like just leave it at that. Like
it gets scary.
It gets really scary, like
cause like, okay, if you don't are you not taking that rejection? Like that's what I'm like, that's what I'm thinking. Like you can't take rejection. It's just like, so now we just can't be friends.
Yeah, like because I hurt your feelings.
Yeah
because I'm like, I guess the one person who you've approached who don't want to have sex with you and you can't handle
yeah
that.
You just can't.
Yeah,
okay,
like all
right, you have fun with that then.
But I'll be thinking people like that, they be doing me a favor anyway because
yeah for
you
sure
you want to press me in my life, no way.
Like that's fine.
Yeah,
I think that's okay then.
Yeah, you
because I don't want to I don't wanna be cool with someone that thinks like that.
Yeah, because
yeah
that's just nasty. And I think that goes back to what we were talking about before with the whole Madonna whore thing, like that kind of relates to men just like viewing sex as a conquest, like we're just something to knock down, like a pawn in the game of them, the game of chess or whatever, you know. And then let us turn around and like, I don't know, enjoy it 1 second. Now we just a hoe and now they slut shaming the fuck out of us, like
go. But right. you just big.
Yeah.
On your knees.
For years.
Yeah. But hey, you got it.
All right. Yeah.
Like you got it.
You ain't got it at this point. Yo, that is just that's just so nasty.
Ugh.
I hate. Like, I don't hate, but I genuinely like dislike how society has just made men feel like they just the shit. Cause it's a woman's world. Fuck with motherfucking James Brown. Well, no, he had a point. Like, it's a man's world, but it wouldn't be nothing without a woman and a girl. That's true, but it's not a man's world. It's really a woman's world. Y'all don't want us to be in power because y'all really feel it.
Really?
Feel it hard.
Girls, we run this mother.
I'm still having withdrawals.
That was funny.
Yeah. But yeah,
I know we talked about misogyny. Mm-hmm. Let's get into the insecure man. Let's get into that. Yeah. I wrote some things.
Okay.
What makes him insecure? No single way to understand how an insecure man is created, suffer from childhood trauma, or haven't recovered from an unhealthy relationship. Mm-hmm. The big two. Mm-hmm. When dealing with the insecure man, here's what to do. Don't blame, but they can be honest about how they feel. Encourage them to contact a therapist. That's what we've been saying the whole time. Mm-hmm. Therapy. Mm-hmm. Hold them accountable for playing mind games and manipulating. Live your own life and save energy for yourself. Offer constructive criticism, not nagging.
You know what?
How do you feel about that?
Okay. I can't deal with an insecure man, and I came to that conclusion. Like,
it's been it's not for me. Like,
you have to be secure in a relationship. I'm so sorry. And if you're not, I don't know how we can fix that. Mm-hmm. Maybe better communication or something. But I'm not gonna have you breathing down my neck.
That's what I'm saying. It's only so much you can give. It was one time I was talking to somebody, and they was kind of giving that. And it was just it made me feel, ugh. Why are you doing this?
Yeah, because even when I was insecure in my relationships, I would try so hard not to let my partner pick mm-hmm. up on that, because I'm like, that's something that I have to deal with within myself.
It's definitely internal.
It's really nothing they can say to make me think, oh, they're not doing this, because if I'm that insecure, mm-hmm. I'm gonna think it anyway. So I really try my hardest not to let them pick up on that, and I would appreciate it if a man would do the same.
Yeah,
because it's you're projecting at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. You have something going on, hurt, trauma from the past or whatever. And so now that's just playing a part in any relationship you have after that. And it's kind of when do you finally stop? And
when is it?
I'm tweaking.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's really what it is.
You got to look at yourself goodness, why am I doing this? Why am I catching an attitude right now? Why am I making these suspicions, and it's nothing to be...
Or why am I asking her who she on the phone with every 5 seconds? Yeah. Or why am I asking her who she texting every 10 minutes? Or why am I making these little slick remarks knowing that she's going to pick up on them, and then getting mad when she pick up on them?
Yeah.
That'd be the thing for me. I'm like... And it's one thing to be jealous, because I'm not going to lie... Jealousy.
That's common. That is common. A common thing.
That's a normal human emotion.
Yeah.
We're human, of course. But don't turn into the green eyed monster, because that's mm-hmm. just weird. That's really fucking weird. And as somebody who has male friends, and as somebody who I won't say keeps in contact, but if I've talked to you or we've dated or mm-hmm. whatever, unless you did something really messed up, and I just cannot forgive you for it, 9 times out of 10 we'll still be cool.
Yeah.
So I'm not gonna act like you don't exist. And some partners, they don't be okay with that, and that's okay. But also, I feel like if you trust your partner, you should be fine with it.
And it's just now that you saying that too, even with the male friends, what's this thing with, your male friends wanna fuck you?
Bro, I hate that, because it's no. I've been single multiple times. If they wanted to, I'm pretty sure they would have.
Yeah, and
on it.
I don't see them that way.
And I don't. So it's even if they do,
yeah,
they know I don't see them that way. We're just cool. Especially if I'm always bringing up my boyfriend. Why do you think they can't read between the lines?
Yeah,
you think they can't pick up on the fact that I'm not interested in them.
No, seriously,
that?
I don't get that. Honestly,
I hate that.
I hate that too.
Because they'll be no, I trust you. I just don't trust him. One, you don't know him. Two. If you trust me, that's fine. That's all that matters.
Yeah, that's fine.
Because like, he's not in a relationship, yeah, that's what I'm so you saying. Don't really have to trust him. But don't if you trust me, that's okay. Yeah. Like, I'm so happy you brought that up because I fucking hate that. That pisses me.
That, I don't know.
Oh, that pisses me off.
And I think it's because, like, any friends, quote unquote, best friends you had.
I didn't think, yeah, like.
I don't know. Maybe it did, maybe it didn't.
Yeah.
But. That don't got
nothing
I don't
to do
know.
With me. Like yeah, that has that nothing to do with me do with because me. I'm with you now for one, and for two, I trust you. So I trust you not to do nothing stupid. If you do something stupid, that's a different story. But until you do something stupid and I see it, you know, I don't care. Like that's your friend.
Yeah.
And I think women should be allowed to have male friends without there being some kind of
rift in
yeah some yeah like because like, why wouldn't you want me to have friends of the opposite
right
sex? Like that's kind of like controlling.
Yeah, and it's kind of like I don't know, like we're all
like
you know?
You're not the only man in the world.
Yeah,
and you're not the only man in the world with a personality that I can mesh with. Okay. So I don't know why you think you're just the shit and you're the only man I need in my life.
That's it. Like I just gotta true. Cut them off.
Yeah, like no thank you, especially if we were friends before I met you. Okay. Oh no.
Yeah.
No. It's not happening. Oh, Bookie, I'm so sorry. Like, and I think men just really have to come back to reality and remember that like they're not the only people that exist. I think men have that really bad. Like the world is theirs. It's not actually. There's like 7 billion people on this planet. You're not one of one.
No, sorry. Like
sorry. Hate to break it to you.
I think so, but
yeah, but you're not. So it's okay to be a little jealous. It's a little cute. It might even, you know, inspire you to step it the fuck up. But, you know, being insecure, that's a whole different thing.
It is.
A whole different thing. And, you know, like Beyonce said, and jealous, you know, if you're keeping your promise, I'm keeping mine. Okay? If you're keeping your promise, it's okay. Because I'm keeping mine. If you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, just know I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. But if you... an insecure man, that'll make me think you cheating on me.
Yeah.
Because why are you so...
Why are you so...
You know, why are you so in my
business?
What you
got going on?
Like, what you...
No, what do you have going on, actually?
Yeah, like...
That be the telltale sign.
That do be the telltale sign. Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes they really just be insecure, but sometimes they do be... They be doing the dirt behind your back, Bookie. Go through that phone. I'm kidding. Don't go through it though. But leave.
Hey. If you want to go through it, let it be the, you know.
You want to hurt your own feelings?
Not you for that. Hey.
I say go for it. Hey.
I never looked through nobody's phone before.
I love that for you.
I don't know. I just kind of.
Every time I went through a phone, I stayed. So there's no point in me going through a phone at this point.
I don't know.
Because I'm a stay.
That's your phone.
Yeah.
I don't want to.
Because I'm not going to lie. Somebody went through my phone and I woke up and I don't even know if he went through my phone, but I woke up and a message was open and I did not open. And I'm like, I knew he opened it.
Yeah.
And it pissed me off because I'm like, why would you do that?
Yeah,
it's kind of like an invasion of privacy.
Yes, it is.
It is.
Like,
so that's why I'm like, now I'm like against going through phones because my dad used to go through my phone when I was in high school. So. I really like I hate that, but when I went through the phones, you know, it was more of like
stomach
I have to
hurting.
Yeah, like I had to hurt my own feelings so that I would build up the emotional strength to leave. But when I went through their phone, they didn't know I went through their phone because I wasn't opening nothing that wasn't already open. That's rule number one. Okay. Don't open shit that ain't been open because then you're telling on yourself.
Got you dropping tips.
For real, then you're telling on yourself. But I'm not endorsing going through the phone because I know how I feel. But if you're going to do it right. That's all I'm saying. Can't tell you what to do now. I can just give you the guide.
We'll let you just take what you will.
Take what you need.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Another thing that be pissing me off about men, now this is just like a... Man,
this would be a lie.
Like
episode.
Eating certain foods to them is gay. How is eating a popsicle gay?
Don't tell me about the like
the hot dogs.
When they take that or the banana. Cause why are you not eating that banana? Why are you not peeling it and buying it?
Yeah. Why are you cutting it? Cutting little pieces.
Like it's fucking.
And then why are you scared to eat a hot dog? When you was a kid, you like hot dogs. But now you're gonna let social media tell you that it's gay to eat a hot dog.
There's nothing gay
about eating anything unless you're a man and it's somebody else's ass. It's another man's ass. Then that's gay.
Even the whole like oh my gosh. I hate pause.
And you know what? I think niggas thought that it was okay to do that because Riley from the Boondocks did that. But what y'all fail to realize is that the Boondocks is a satire. They're making fun of you niggas.
Literally.
They're making fun of y'all. And y'all are so done with the joke go over your heads. Like, saying pause after anything that might sound quote unquote gay is crazy. Because why do you care that much?
Why are you doing that?
It's fine. Yeah, like when I bent over to pick up the pause.
It's not funny. I don't think it's funny. I think it's cringy. I think you need to stop.
Yeah, I think you need
even
to seek
the
help.
Sus. Stop. Yeah. Don't say that.
Because like, I just want people, like, I want men and society in general to realize that nothing is gay. Unless you come out and say it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Unless you come out and say I'm gay.
Yeah.
It's fine.
It's fine. And it's like, nothing is gay except for having sex with the person of the same gender. That is gay. So you eating a hot dog is not gay. You bending over to pick something up and somebody just so happens to be, like, another man just happens to be walking behind you, that's not gay because you had to pick something up.
Like, it's okay.
And he's not bending you over and pumping you from the back. I have to get, I have to get descriptive y'all really can understand what I'm talking about. Like, that is just so dumb. It's childish. Like,
it's so childish. You're 30, 29, and you're still saying pause at this big age?
That's something my brother would do. At his big age of, like, 32, I think he is.
Like, cut it out.
Like, come
stop
on
that.
How old are we?
No one's gonna look at you and say, oh, that man is gay.
Yeah.
No one cares.
Nobody, like, and I think that's what men fail to realize. Like, nobody care about y'all the way y'all think we do. Like, nobody is watching to see you eat that banana.
Yeah.
So that they can be like, ooh, nigga, you gay. Nobody cares.
Just eat it. Eat the
like,
banana.
Even Mace and Cameron, they have, like, this sports show, sports podcast or whatever called It Is What It Is or whatever. Mm. And Cameron has always been, like, very much, like, pause. He say pause
he
after
give me that,
everything.
Though.
And I like Cameron's music, but it be making me so mad because it's like, I don't want to support you at this point because why do you care that much? Cameron, we all know you're not gay. You're fucking Cameron. Even if you were gay, you're fucking Cameron. Like, you'll be wearing pink fucking chinchilla furs, but you draw the line at saying something.
Like,
what?
It's definitely a head scratcher.
It's a real big head scratcher because why do you care that much? Like, and why are you trying to pick your words out that carefully so that nothing you say can come off as gay? It's just weird. Like, I don't think people, especially like black men, I don't think they realize that the more homophobic you are on this kind of scale, the more I think that you're hiding something and you're kind of insecure.
For
in what you
sure.
have going on.
Something's. Go ahead. For your pride.
For your pride.
Don't hide.
And I'm not going to say that every person who is, like, very homophobic like this, because that's what it is. It's homophobia.
It is.
Let's just put that out there. Let's put a word on it. You might not think you're homophobic, but baby, you're homophobic. But I'm not going to say that every person that is, like, homophobic like this is DL, because that's kind of, like, that's a slap in the face to gay people. But it's just, like, it does make me question, like, well, why do you care this
for
much?
Sure.
Like, why are they on your mind this much?
For
like,
sure.
Rilo Rodriguez.
Yeah.
He mentioned Zaya Wade in 3 songs.
Oh, my gosh. And even, like, just Boosie, I hate him.
He should be back in jail.
Like, bro, okay, y'all got me. Yes, I still struggle.